Welcome to One Man's Movies, Films of the Year 2016. This was my 2016 at the movies.
Brace for impact.
Superhero story.
This changes things.
I want to be a wizard.
I'm Bob Mann, the movie man.
Why did you say that name?
Because my name's Bob, and I know the movies. Get over it! My top 10 films of 2016 are perhaps not technically the best films of the year, and many of them certainly will not trouble the major awards coming up. But they all in some ways managed to enthrall, delight, or surprise me. So how did I choose my top 10 films of the year?
Would that it were this is simple.
This was hard. 2016 might not go down as a classic year for cinema, and there were a number of outright disappointments such as Star Trek Beyond and Inferno, for example. But there were also an awful lot of great films to choose from, and cutting that down to just 10 was really difficult. So let's get to business with my number 10.
Welcome to Nerve, a game like Truth or Dare, minus the truth. Watchers pay to watch, players play to win, cash and glory. Are you a watcher or a player? Are you a watcher or a player? Are you a watcher, player, watch player?
Nerve is a teenage flick, and to be honest, it's a bit of a B-movie. But what struck me about it was its energy, its style, its topicality, coming out as it did in the heart of the Pokemon Go craze of last summer, and the vivacity of its young stars. Emma Roberts, niece of Julia Roberts, and Dave Franco, younger brother of Tom and James. And number 9 is Margot Robbie, naked in a bubble bath. But I'm not that shallow. Or am I? Adam McKay's The Big Short is a real ensemble piece, but features some heavyweight star power in the form of Ryan Gosling, Christian Bale, Steve Carell, and of course Brad Pitt. Having lost a significant amount of money personally in a failed US property deal in the late noughties, this is a pretty hard film for me to watch, but it is worth it as it's done extremely well. Intelligent and requiring your full attention, this is a film that I can watch again and again, and for that reason it makes my number 9 slot.
You just bet against the American economy.
Dad, it's okay.
Number 8 is Jeff Nichols' sci-fi film Midnight Special. This might be a bit of a Marmite film in that some people might love it and others might hate it. But for me, as a thinly veiled tribute to one of my favourite films of all time, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, it was mesmerising. The story of the lead character played by Michael Shannon apparently kidnapping a strange, light-sensitive boy from a religious cult was both mysterious and gripping. The script assumes an audience IQ well in excess of 100 by only revealing its plot points in stages. A really great screenplay. With a great supporting cast, including Kirsten Dunst, Joel Edgerton, and Sam Shepard, this is a great sci-fi come road trip movie that is truly memorable.
You'll have no clue what you're dealing with, do you?
And my number 7, A Shark Tale. Like Midnight Special, The Shallows is a low-budget but very tight and well-constructed little film. Blake Lively, who fills out an orange bikini extremely nicely, plays a surfer babe who gets into trouble a few hundred yards offshore an isolated beach. Attacked by a very persistent shark, she clings to a rock with the choice of either waiting for high tide and certain death or swimming through it. Possibly by virtue of the low budget, the film meters out its special effects frugally, focusing more on reaction shots, and that adds greatly to the suspense of the film. Despite cursed with a rather lame ending, this was a great premise and an entertaining night out at the flicks.
Give me your left arm.
No!
Yeah, come on.
No.
When you're talking to your doctor,
no.
You tell him you have a spiral fracture.
No!
Deep breath.
No.
And number six is an anarchic, violent, and at times very rude, comedic buddy movie, The Nice Guys. Russell Crowe would not be a natural choice as a lead comedy role, but here, paired with Ryan Gosling, the duo make a memorable double act. The film also notably features young Australian actress Anguri Rice as Crowe's morally centred and very bright daughter, Holly, who just about steals every scene she's in.
You're the world's worst detective.
The world's worst.
Set in 70s LA with some really nice period touches, The Nice Guys is hilarious in places, and seldom have I laughed out loud more often at the cinema in 2016 as with this one.
A major weapons test is imminent. We need to know how to destroy it.
Making my number five slot is Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, although why they exactly needed that suffix added to the title is beyond me. This is a real return to form for Star Wars, with Felicity Jones feisty and dynamic as Jyn Erso, a young rebel leader out with a small force to steal the plans for the Death Star. Although a little uneven in pace, particularly at the beginning of the film when there's a lot of CGI planet hopping, the film builds to a memorable and moving finale that's truly Shakespearean in its scope. I just can't wait for the sequel.
There isn't much time.
Do you ever feel like your life has turned into something you never intended?
Tom Ford's second film is a multi-layered telling of Amy Adams' vacuous existence as an LA art dealer. Shaken to the core when she receives, out of the blue, a cutting manuscript from her ex-husband, played by Jake Gyllenhaal. The cinematography deliciously changes from the cold blue tones of her LA reality to the rosy glow of her past memories of young love, through to the harsh hues of the story within the story, a truly horrific journey into darkness in the Texan desert. I've seen review comments that says this was over-designed and too perfect. All I can say to that is, I just love perfection.
Do you remember how Alice wasn't always in Wonderland?
She fell down, 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 deep in a hole.
Into the top three, and at number three, we have Room. Despite having a horrendous trailer that gave far too much away, this was a really special drama concerning a teenage girl who was locked away in room against her will by a Joseph Fritzl-starred character. Born into that claustrophobic life is her young son, who knows of no other existence. This was a justifiable Oscar win last year for Brie Larson, but also fabulous was the young Jason Tremblay as a young boy. Gripping, moving, and really getting to the heart of the damage that these evil people do to whole families, Room well deserves its position at my number three slot. There's a land that's clear and
bright. Morning, class.
Good morning, it's Justina.
You might find my number two choice a real surprise. A zombie pick. Yeah, a zombie pick at number two. The Girl with All the Gifts transcends most of the other dubious picks for me in this genre. A genuinely intelligent treatment of apocalyptic goings-on, building the tension between two forces. On the one hand, the maternal love felt by a teacher, played by Gemma Arterton, for one of her young pupils, played with great style by young Senia Nanua. On the other hand, the desperate search for a cure by a scientist, played by Glenn Close, supported by no-nonsense military man, Paddy Considine. This is a career best for Glenn Close, and her final scenes in this film should become a lesson in effective acting. Again, done on a shoestring budget, you can actually make nearly 50 of this film for the price of Batman v Superman. The director has eked out every cent of that budget on the screen. Recommended.
Oh my god.
Go, go.
Mama, what's going to happen?
I don't know.
So, we've reached number one, and it's another sci-fi flick, but what a flick. Arrival was a film I went to see without any expectations whatsoever. The film's trailer suggested that this was going to be another Close Encounters meets Independence Day. I'm normally really critical of trailers that give too much of the plot away, but in this case, the trailer gave absolutely nothing away about the fundamental story that lies underneath the alien visitation wrapping. Central performances by Amy Adams and Jeremy Renner were excellent, and the twists when they came were novel and unexpected. Even the exposure of the aliens was done well, with no need for sniggering at dodgy plastic monsters or fake CGI effects. Director Denis Villeneuve will hopefully now forgive me for leaving his Sicario out of my top 10. This is a film I expect to do very well at the Oscars in a few months' time.
Do trust me.
So, that's my eclectic choice of my top films for 2016. Clearly I didn't get to see as many of the hundreds of films that get released in the year as I would have liked. I do have a day job. Perhaps one of those I missed was one of your personal favourites, in which case I can only apologise. Please let me know in the comments your thoughts and what I got wrong. Wrong? How very dare you. Thanks for following One Man's Movies, and here's hoping for another bumper crop of films in 2017. Bye, see you soon.